Hi, I'm John Swartz. I'm here in Katati Speed Shop. We're going to be working today. We're going to be doing some TIG welding. We're going to be using the Diversion 180. The project we're working on is a perfect home hobbyist, personal user style project. We're actually going to be making an air box for Mike Brown, who happens to be Zane's very first paying customer. His truck, it's a 48 Ford pickup truck. It's a custom air box he designed, and we're going to be doing some aluminum TIG welding on it today. To start off with, the material cleanliness is always going to be an issue. So we've already Scotch-Brited the material we're going to be welding. And we've got some 5356 aluminum filler material right here. I already cut it in half to make it easier for me to use. And what's going to be unique about this project is that we've got, you know, different thicknesses of material we're going to be working on. So how we compensate for that will be kind of the fun that we've got here. The good thing about the Diversion family of products is basically all you need to know is your material type and your material thickness. So we know we're working on aluminum. So it's just a matter of switching back and forth on the selection button, switch it over to aluminum. And then based off of my material thickness chart down below, well, we know we're working on some 3/16, and the pieces I'm going to be working on here in a little bit are actually 1/4 inch. So the machine's maxed out, but they're relatively small, so that we should be able to do that without too much difficulty. So what we're going to be welding here is what would be the bottom portion of the air pan. This would be what sits on top of the carburetors. The thickness of the material we're working with here are actually a little bit thicker than what the rating of the machine is. We're looking at some 1/4 inch, but as long as your weldment is relatively small and you can get a puddle started, you should be able to work through this right here. All right, so that piece is all done. What Mike wanted is with those flange pieces that mount to the top of the carburetors, he wanted a complete air seal, so we actually welded all the way around. Another option, if you're really concerned with any type of warpage or anything like that, we could have done some skip welds around, put in some like silicone or something like that from a sealing perspective, but for this, it's a little bit easier just to weld it and we didn't get any warpage. The next piece we're going to be working on is the main body of the air pan itself. We're going to be welding the side rail to the main body base. We're just going to be doing some fillet welds on the inside. Mike wanted it so that aesthetically you can't really see those welds, and we're probably going to be doing another skip weld all the way around to prevent some warpage, yet still give another tight air seal on the inside. So we got a 1/2 inch plate down below. We're definitely outside the maximum capability of this machine, but you know, just like anybody else in their garage, they're going to run into situations where they've got a thick application. How do you get around it? Well, with aluminum, actually any material, it's pretty easy. We're just going to throw a little preheat into that thicker material just to make it easier for the puddle to wet out into that, and we should be able to make our bead quite a bit easier then. One little trick when you weld, you always want to try to get yourself in the best position possible to make the easiest type of weld. All we did here with this piece is I just tipped it up. Makes it a little bit easier for me. Instead of just doing just a straight fillet, it's more of like a flat groove type weld, and just a little bit easier access. All right, we got the upright in the bottom portion of the pan welded in. It's welded all the way around. It was a little difficult at first, just using the power the machine put out. But after we put the preheat in, things went along pretty smoothly. Now we're gonna be putting in the bottom of the air pan. It's already set in place. I'm gonna actually be doing little skip welds here to prevent too much warpage. It'll be welded all the way around. So the top, or the, what would actually be the bottom portion of the air pan, and this is where the carburetors, we can flip this over. This bottom portion here is 1/4 inch. We welded that to the 1/8 inch uprights. So all it took was just a little bit of manipulation of the heat of the torch. Obviously the machine had more than enough capability of doing this. And we just skip welded around just to prevent any additional warpage. Obviously this has to go on top of an engine. It has to lay flush with the carburetor, so we want to minimize that as much as possible. We got the backside of the air box welded in. Right now we're just going to be putting the smaller piece right here in the front to seal it all off. This is about 1/16 inch thick. We're going to be welding it to the side, which again is 1/8 inch. And overall, this project is a good example of being able to weld multiple thicknesses of material together in one weldment, even with a machine that may not necessarily be rated for certain thicknesses, how to overcome that. Adding some preheat, directing your torch toward the thicker material, working it up into the thinner material. But something like this is a common application for somebody building their own hot rod or any other home project in their garage.